the short put back as Taylor trying to get off the snide with an early three. Again, they're working with Sullinger, and Robinson comes in, reaches in.
Boy, cheap foul there for Thomas
Robinson.
Very much
so. I agree with you, Steve. No reason. Withy has Sullinger in good, under good control. No reason for Robinson to come in and reach and commit the fouls. He's, Withy had him in good position.
The official stats.
How do you figure? I think they'll go back and correct that. I didn't see Relaford anywhere in the play.
No, nor did I. And here is the three by Smith. And there is an X factor right there.
I agree, Jim. He was the key guy in that Syracuse win, hitting the big shots in the second half. And I think the shooting of both William Buford and Smith Jr. will be huge here for Ohio State.
Well, Smith Jr.'s numbers are up considerably in tournament play as Sullinger able to challenge with the inside. Smith shooting 47%.
Sullinger three-point line. Hits the turnaround shot over Withy.
You know, Withy likes to block shots from the weak side. I don't know if he's as good.
We were taking issue with the foul call on Relaford instead of Thomas Robinson. And this is Relaford highlighted here with our virtual madness. And it's Robinson reaching in. Relaford nowhere near. And it's been confirmed. They called the foul. As you see, Robinson actually hits him in the face. Foul has not been changed, and that would have been one early against Robinson.
How was that?
Hey, they just changed it. They just made the announcement here, and they have changed it back to Robinson. So the steal made by Sullinger.
And he's pretty quick laterally, too, able to slide his feet awfully well.
Kraft back out high. Sullinger stepping in. Kraft will take the jumper. He hits it.
Good play by Jared Sullinger to not try to force it. Use the dribble to draw defenders and get Kraft an open jump shot there.
Kraft, a selective three-point shooter. He was just 2 for 8 in the tournament to this point. For him, look for them in the half court.
In and out for Robinson.
That's a good look for Kansas, though, when he's able to catch it in the sweet spot of the low post.
Kraft out to Sullinger. Perfect pass. Bounced in there for the assist, and Sullinger has two more.
Tucky.
Here is Sam Thompson on the floor, number 12. We haven't actually seen, and Scott on the floor earlier. It's Thompson out here first off the bench. It's Sullinger, and Withy thought he had a clean play. That'll be the first foul on the 7-footer for Kansas.
I don't think they gave it to Withy. I think it may have been Tehan, Jim. Oh, maybe not.
It is on Tehan. So, Sullinger at the line. He averages almost 9 free throws a game during the tournament.
Interesting thing with both Sullinger and Thomas Robinson. They each struggle with length, you know, and so they both really have to get position before they get the ball.
Low pinned underneath to the corner. Tehan off the front of the rim. Young saves it.
Young is an excellent offensive rebounder. Wild shot, but there's Young again.
Clean block by Sullinger. Young driving in and going the other way. They've drawn another charge. This time it's the fresh.
They really have struggled in the tournament.
Thomas, this is a 2. Tap Sullinger. Tap again. And finally, it's Johnson.
No numbers. When he does that, he's a hard guy to defend. Nice look by Thomas.
Sullinger rattles it home.
Big time finish by Jared Sullinger, but I like the pass there.
Yeah.
Good job by Lindzell Smith to pull that pumpkin out of traffic for Kansas to have a chance to cut into this deficit. Jared Sullinger took a shot to the face, and Kevin Young going to be whistled for the foul.
Yeah, he got a pretty good smack in the face there.
I agree, Clark. I mean, they can't score enough in the half court unless Robinson really dominates. You look at the numbers, 0 transition points for Kansas, 0 free throws. So there's just nothing easy, as you see the replay of...
Yeah, inadvertent hand to the face. Yeah, no elbow there, just an inadvertent hand.
The officials will review this.
Right.
But it'd be surprising to see a flagrant one called. I can't imagine. But Kansas has to find a way to turn Ohio State over and get out in transition. You know, five turnovers right now for Ohio State. Zero fast break points for Kansas. So you've got to figure out a way to break through.
Six turnover on the Buckeyes. What about Sellinger's play so far, Clark?
Well, he's been solid. The big guy knows how to use his body. He's got a nice touch. Good active defense there. Breaking contact. Tough finish. But his presence really elevates the confidence level of this team, and it gives them another option.
A very capable three-point shooter. Made 50 of them on the year. Just 3 of 15 in the tournament coming into this game, though.
There's Thomas. Tapped up and in by Sellinger.
For the penetration of Thomas.
Tehan. Lead. Thomas. Well, Thomas Robinson, I thought, was going to grab hold of it. Unable to.
I think Sellinger got a hand on that one, Jim, from behind. Deep post position.
There is Sellinger banking it in.
That's when he's at his best. Not trying to back a guy down, but seal him in. Mismatch here. Kevin Young trying to defend Sellinger.
Here's Buford. He's had a hand. Sellinger trying to go up with it. And Young got a piece of the hand. Tomorrow on 60 Minutes, is sugar toxic? Well, you'll hear from a doctor who says it's causing an American health crisis. That's tomorrow on 60 Minutes, only CBS. Young's third foul, Sellinger to shoot two.
That opportunity, guys, was created because Sellinger passed it quickly out of the double team.
Yeah.
And when he was able to get it to the weak side, Buford had a shot, and he was still mismatched on Young and beat him to the offensive glass.
And the reason that pass was available was because Withy is on the bench. Young just too small for Sellinger, so they dropped.
Little hook shot, no. And tapped out to Elijah Johnson. Blocked by Sellinger.
Excellent defense by Jared Sellinger. He broke contact.